Hey everybody, welcome back to another real estate town hall. Today is Friday, April 17th, and I wanted to come to you live just to talk to you a little bit. Just kind of a market update. So today we don't have any guests. You're stuck with me. And I just wanted to talk about a couple of things. We've gotten a lot of questions over the past couple of days. Hopefully many of you are watching right now and you can hear us. Give me a thumbs up, maybe give us a share, like. Feel free to comment live. You can comment live. If you'd like to be on the show, you can comment too. I can actually bring you on the show with us if you'd like to ask a question or if you have a comment. But we're going to talk just a couple of different topics. I'm going to share my screen here and just kind of run you through a couple of updates that we're seeing. Just for those of you that haven't seen one of our webinars or haven't been on one of the interviews that we've been talking on here, just kind of like as we're doing closings, you know, people like, are you closed? I mean, if you saw our NBC piece, you know that we are not closed. We were deemed an essential business. At first, realtors were not deemed essential, and then that eventually got changed. So, you know, from an industry perspective, and we'll talk a little bit more about the market towards the end of the video, we are seeing people doing business. We are seeing agents writing contracts. Investors are still buying deals. Are we going to have a big foreclosure crisis? We don't really know at this point. Depends how long it lasts. But I don't see the real estate market taking that big of a hit. So I'm going to share the screen here. And we're going to just talk a little bit about some cool topics, just some things that we see in the market going on, give you a little education. So the first question we have are remote closings. With all the big hype about remote closings, and if your office is closed, how do you do closings? Because yes, our office is open, but as you know, due to CDC guidelines, we shut the office down to the public. So if you need to drop something off, we do have a lockbox outside that you are able to drop documents at. But as far as our office, it is closed to the public. So we talk about remote closings, and this is the new big hype. Everyone's trying to get what's called RON, R-O-N, RON certified, which stands for Remote Online Notarization. As some of you have seen, the Florida law was passed January 1st. Where remote online notarizations were allowed to take place in Florida, meaning myself as a licensed and bonded notary in the state of Florida can conduct similar to like a Zoom interview or a Skype interview or FaceTime. We can actually conduct a face-to-face via video camera remote notarization. Now, the caveat I want to tell you is we've been doing remote online notarizations. I actually looked it up since January of 2018. And some of you are probably saying, well, if the law just changed January of 2020, how are you doing it? And it was because our national underwriter, our partner Westcor, was willing to underwrite the risk of documents being notarized with a Virginia or a Texas notary, which had remote online notarization statutes passed, meaning that you would do your closing on video with a notary that is sitting physically in the states that allow it, where now Florida is one of them. So you could actually sit with myself or one of our team members on video conference and do a closing, where before you would just do it with a third party closer. So that is how remote closings happen. They are very easy. It's all you need is a video camera. We bring witnesses on and you know, we witness the documents, we notarize the documents, and then we'll talk in a minute about what we do with them after the fact. So we have a new page on our website, which we posted on our Facebook page today, that you can see that talks about the online process and how we do it as far as DocuSign for the documents. And we use the online remote notarization to notarize all of our notarized documents. And then we use a program called Simplifile, which is e-recording, which we've actually been doing since 2013. So we've been ready for this. It's almost, we've gotten all of this done over the last several years to be able to conduct fully automated closings. So when this global pandemic hit, as your trusted title company, we were ready to execute the plan that we've already been doing in order to deliver the same level of service that you as a customer deserve. So now we're going to talk about mobile notaries. Do they still exist? You know, one of the questions, are mobile notaries still working? More now than ever. So we are no longer using our in-house closers to actually conduct a closing in the office or go out of the office. We are keeping our staff safe in the house, and we are using remote notaries that will come to your house and notarize the physical documents, practicing safe CDC guideline procedures. So they will actually bring the documents to you, drop them off. We can explain them to you. They wear gloves, they wear a mask. They can actually watch you through the window. if you choose, in order to get these documents notarized, and then they'll bring them back to our office. So we have the notaries locally here that are doing that process. They will be happy to take the documents to you if you do not feel comfortable doing the online, or you're not up to speed on the technology in order to be able to get that online notary. The other issue is that lenders, a lot of lenders, we've only seen maybe two or three lenders that actually allow the online remote notarization program. So we are seeing some online remote notarization happening with the lenders, but it's not as many as you would think. It used to be a lot more, and now we're starting to see a lot less. So we have, you know, two or three, they're hopping on board, and now we're gonna start seeing more and more ad as it becomes accustomed to. But some of them are doing it for refinances, not really for purchases. So if you're buying a home, or if you're a real estate agent and you have a client buying a home, if they're getting a loan, we're probably gonna have to send a closer somewhere to you in order to get these documents notarized. The next one I want to talk about are different notary solutions. So we covered a couple of them. We have, again, as we said, our remote online notarization option. That's where you're going to do a video conference. One of the things with that you have to remember is you must be a U.S. citizen or a U.S. resident. You must have a social security number or a tax ID number, and you must have, I believe it's 5 years of credit history, because we are going to do what's called a soft pull on your credit. So it will not affect your credit score, but we do a soft pull, kind of like when you apply for a credit card or a car loan, and they're going to ask you certain security questions, like maybe which type of car did you own? What street did you live on? Maybe a maiden name. They're going to ask you maybe a type of account that you had, and you have to answer all the questions right in order to be verified. So it's actually more secure than sitting with your typical notary, because how do they know that ID was you? It may have looked like you 75 pounds ago, 5 years ago. So it may not actually look like you. So this is a little bit more of a secured system. The other option is, obviously, we talked about, we can send the notary to you. That's always another option. They will come to you, practice safe guidelines, and get the documents notarized. And the third option is, feel free to visit your own notary, get your own documents notarized, and then you would be able to FedEx them back to our office or have a courier drop them off. So those are kind of the three different notary options that we have available. Many, many solutions. We're very solution-based here at Independence Title. So whatever you need, we're happy to deliver some solutions to you that solve your problem. Just want to give a shout out to Mr. Anish from BRIA, Broward Real Estate Investors Association. If you check out their Facebook page, we are going to be doing a live webinar with them next week on the 22nd. So thanks for giving me a little comment there. I appreciate the plug there for being one of your favorite title companies. But we are going live with them. We're going to talk a lot about different technologies for the real estate agent, for the investors. We're going to talk about SBA loans, which, as you know, I'm up to speed on these SBA loans. I've become an SBA expert to make sure that we can keep our doors open and we can maximize whatever programs that the city, county, and the federal government have been offering to the small businesses. So we're definitely up on that. So any questions, feel free to ask us. Municipal and county closures, that's another big hot topic. Now, remember, when we talk about permit issues and lien search issues, now remember, liens, which is weird, is not covered in title insurance. Liens are not recorded in the public record. Liens are gonna be considered code violations, code matters, code issues, permitting issues, open, closed, and expired permits, as well as utility bills. These are not covered by title insurance. So if a municipality is closed, meaning let's say the city of Tamarack is closed and they cannot provide us the data, the buyer can choose to either close, or the buyer can choose to wait until it opens to get us the data that they would need. Some of them are online, some of them are closed, but we are seeing more and more of them are just closed to the public, but they are still there working just like we are at the title company to provide the data that you need in order to get you the search that you need in order to close. So when we have a whole list of them. If you have any questions, you can always ask us. Our lien search company, we have many that we use, but our two favorites are providing daily updates to give us the update as to which cities are closed, which ones are working remotely, which ones are open and only providing services via online. So we definitely have that data. So just remember, though, when you talk about that those are items that are not covered in title insurance. We are covering anything that would be recorded in the public records: mortgages, liens, judgments, bankruptcies, HOA liens, foreclosures, things like that would actually be recorded in the public record. These are all items that are unrecorded. Again, code enforcement matters, permit matters. Again, not covered in title insurance, so you want to make sure you talk to your title company early on in the stage to make sure, is the municipality open and can we deliver the search that you need in order to get your deal closed? Talking about unrecorded issues, one of the other items that we are seeing is we can close without having a HOA estoppel letter. Obviously, if the condo requires an approval by the board, you know, that we cannot waive unless you take exception. We can close without an estoppel letter, but understand that a lot of the homeowners associations are closed and they are not, I repeat that, they are not producing the certificate of approval. So they're not going through the interview process. They're probably waiting it out to see if this passes sooner than later. If not, then they're going to have to come up with some type of Zoom interview. I'm actually the vice president of my homeowners association, and we were on Zoom last night for our board meeting. We voted on many items. We had a lot of the homeowners on there asking questions. So it's actually a great platform. So hopefully the associations are going to figure out how to get that technology available in order to get those deals closed and approved. Gap coverage. This is another big hot topic. Again, most of you have never even heard of gap coverage because it's never really been a problem. But gap coverage is basically the gap in time from the time we close till the time the documents get recorded. This is a big deal in many other states other than Florida. For those of you, as I said earlier, we've been doing electronic recording since 2013. If my buddy Alex is watching, who used to do it for many, many years, he knows that most of the counties were not online. Magically, ever since the COVID-19 hit, every county in the state of Florida, with the exception of one, is on e-recording. Go figure. It took a global pandemic to get them to catch up to technology. One of the main cities was the county of Okeechobee. Okeechobee County refused to go online, and it was a pain to have to mail the documents. If there was something wrong, they'd mail them back regular mail. You'd have to go back and forth and back and forth. E-recording makes it so much simpler. All we do is simply scan in the original documents to a high-resolution 600 DPI scanner. We upload them to the county, and in some cases, they are recorded within 20 to 30 minutes. Broward County is instant. Miami used to be 7 days, and now they're actually recording documents within a day to a day and a half. And then Palm Beach is a little bit behind. I'm not sure why. Maybe they had a technology issue or a staffing issue. They're a little bit behind, but the documents are still getting recorded faster than if we had to actually print a check, mail it to the county, wait for them to open the FedEx or the US mail, and then have someone record the documents. So this is a great feature. Again, we've been doing it since 2013, but why would it take a global pandemic for our industry to catch up to this? Realtors have been signing via DocuSign for many, many, many years. And it's mind-boggling that it took this long for the counties to catch up. But Broward, Miami, and Palm Beach have been fantastic. They've been on e-recording for a long time. And then it was just a matter of getting the other counties up to speed. So the last thing I wanted to talk about, kind of a little market update of what we're seeing here as we're going to wrap up this interview. I try not to take it more than 15 or 20 minutes. I know, Anish, it's crazy. Anish here from Bria saying it's crazy to see that it takes a pandemic for e-recordings. It really is amazing. But now we can get these deeds recorded, close that gap in time, get that buyer their insurance policy and their deed recorded as quick as possible. So again, great comment there, Anish. Thank you. So market, kind of a market update. I've seen amazing things happening in the market. Are we lighter? I'm not going to lie to you and say we're not. Are we closing 100 deals? Are we closing 80 deals? Absolutely not. Business is down slightly, but we are still closing deals. We're closing 3 to 5 deals a day. So if you do the math, if there's 20 days and we close, you know, 3 or 4 deals a day, that's still quite a bit of closings in order to get done with this market. So realtors, they are still writing contracts. They're just practicing proper CDC guidelines. So they may be visiting a house without anybody in the house, or maybe only visiting vacant houses. I just had an inspection done at my grandmother's house that we're selling, and the inspector had to go there when nobody was there. They went to the house completely empty. They didn't want the buyer. They didn't want the seller. They didn't want a tenant. They didn't want anybody. The appraiser, the same thing. So as long as you're practicing proper safe measures, virtual tours are great. And I don't want to spill the beans too much on some of the different technology, because that's going to be saved for our presentation with Bria next week. We also have a lot of great guests coming on. Actually, next week on Monday, we have a fantastic guest coming on who's in the tax field, going to be talking about SBA loans and how they're able to reach out to resources they have in other states in order to file these PPP loans. and the EIDL loans, the economic injury disaster loans, which are huge right now. For those of you that saw the government ran out of money and they cut them off, don't worry. As always, they're going to print more money. You just need to make sure you get in the queue and bank local. You know, you want to make sure you're banking with a local bank, that you're a name, not a number. I can tell you at our bank, we are a name. We are a name with our banker. Our banker has my cell phone number. I have their cell phone number. We can reach out to our banker at Center State anytime and ask any questions. So we get white glove service. So you get pushed to the front of the line in getting these items done when you work with a smaller bank, because they're going to take care of their local clients as opposed to larger banks that are nationwide, if not worldwide. You know, you're just a number there and you fall to the bottom of the list. I had actually one of my good friends called me and said, you know, I banked with Citibank. They banked with Citibank for 18 years and they couldn't even get someone on the phone to answer their questions to help them file the application for the PPP loan. So you want to make sure you have your tools of the trade, which in this case is a great banker. We use Center State Bank in Coral Springs. Kendra's fantastic. You want to make sure you have a great CPA. And you want to make sure you have a great payroll company. If you're doing those things yourself, you're going to have a hard time getting your documents together in order to get them filed. So as far as the market, we see contracts are coming in, deposits are coming in. We just received a huge deposit, over $200,000 on a deal. So the high-end market is moving, the lower-end market is moving. And I'm going to tell you where we're hearing some of the challenges are for those of you that are doing this part-time, or you were doing it maybe just a little bit above part-time, you're going to have a hard time. But for our clients, our investors, and our agents that are focusing on closing, if you're a realtor and you're closing 1 to 2 deals a month consistently, you're going to be okay. If you're an investor and you're wholesaling 5 deals a month, you're going to be okay. You may only do 3 deals. You may have to cut back on expenses, but you're going to be okay. A little plug for our book, Rescue Your Business. Now's the time more than ever to get that book. We have some at the office. You can always message us. We will be happy to mail you a copy. But these big people are going to fail. The big buyers. See, Anish again, Anish. I don't know if you're the only one watching or commenting here. It says we got a bunch of people on, but see, Anish said our big buyers are still buying, dying for more properties. Cash is king right now. Those that are over leveraged are going to be in trouble. They're going to have a problem. Those that are only doing a limited amount of deals, 1 or 2 deals every couple of months, you're going to have a problem surviving, because that 1 or 2 deals every couple of months is going to dry up to 1 or 2 deals every 6 months. And you may have a problem. But that's where we come into play. We wrote the book about our troubles we had in 2008 and how we survived and rebuilt it and created strategies so it doesn't happen again. So I encourage you all to grab a copy of Rescue Your Business. You can get it from our website right on Amazon, and you'll have it probably by Saturday or Monday via Prime. And just make sure that you're able to read that book and understand, you know, one of the things that is helping us through this global pandemic, we have not received any of the funding from the government agencies yet. But one of the things to understand is that, you know, we're okay because we can cut back on expenses. And instead of doing 80 deals a month, 70 deals a month, we're doing 50 deals a month. And we can still survive on 50, 55, or 60 deals a month because we've planned properly. So my message to you today is plan properly for a storm that is hitting right now. So if you plan properly, when the storm comes, you won't have a problem. And if you think we're not going to have a storm after this, you're mistaken, because whether the shift in the economy is going to come this year, next year, the year after, we don't know, but plan now for the rainy day tomorrow. So I encourage you to pick up a copy of that book. If you email in our office, if you email David, our office, David@titlerate.com, David@titlerate.com, he'll be happy to put a copy of the book in the mail free of charge to you. We'll drop you a copy. Just make sure you read it. Make sure you read it and learn some of the strategies in there. So that's all I have today. I just wanted to kind of hop on for 15 or 20 minutes. We're just at the 20-minute mark. I appreciate all of you watching our live feed. Please follow our Facebook page here. If you found it on the Independence Title Facebook page, please like it. Please share it. Please send us a comment. Make sure you follow us on YouTube. We go live on YouTube as well. And next week, I believe we have a lineup 4 of the 5 days, and we're working on something huge. When I tell you huge, we're bringing in a huge international name in the real estate industry to hop on. We were able to get him for about a 10-minute Q&A. So look out for that. We're going to be announcing that coming soon. We're just working out the final details, but we want to make sure we bring some added value. So again, next week, we're talking about lien searches and permits. We have some tax questions. I believe we have someone coming on talking about private lending. So we have a whole lineup of guests coming up next week to give you a little market update, a little bit about what they do and where they see their industry. Because in this new market of a global pandemic, we want to make sure we deliver the value to you in the comfort of your home, your office, your car, right on your cell phone. So again, thanks for watching. We appreciate it. Watching the real estate town hall here. Any questions, please reach out, let me know. And as always, we look forward to seeing you at the closing table. Have a great day, everyone. Have a great weekend and stay safe with your family. We'll see you on Monday.